It's the Weather Xtreme video. This is the afternoon edition. This is for Thursday, the 23rd of September. I'm James Spann. Alabama's weather beautiful through the weekend with a really dry air mass in place. Here we go. This is the upper air look across the country this afternoon. Got a deep upper low north of the state, troughing over the eastern U.S., and hard to find a decent cloud in the sky. That's the visible satellite view. It's clear across the state. We'll be dry for quite a while. Temperatures way below average. These were captured about 130. Birmingham at 71. We should be at 85 this time of the year based on seasonal averages. And around the region, temperatures are mostly in the 70s. It's delightful, even down in places like New Orleans and Mobile. There's the watch warning map. Flash flood watch is in effect for parts of New Jersey, New York, and Pennsylvania. Got a marginal risk of severe storms up in that same area through tonight. Tomorrow, a marginal risk over parts of New England. And day three, which is Saturday, much of the country in a very stable, dry air mass. Rain for the next 7 days, just not much. Basically nothing for Alabama through the end of next week. So let's look at the tropics. We've got three systems to watch, three areas of interest. We have the disturbance up in the North Atlantic. That's the ghost of Odette with a medium chance of redeveloping. We have a wave that's well to the east of the Bahamas, southeast of Bermuda, and Tropical Storm Sam. This is the five-day outlook. And again, you can see Odette, the remnants of Odette, with a medium chance of getting its act together again, drifting to the south. That disturbance that's southeast of Bermuda, drifting to the north, we're not going to worry too much about those. The focus, obviously, will be on Sam, a tropical storm with 50-mile-per-hour winds. This will likely become a major hurricane, Category 3, by early next week on Monday, at some point to the east of the Leeward Islands. The guidance suggesting that the system will start to gain latitude, passing north of the Leeward Islands early next week. And out there in the longer range, this is the GFS ensemble. The members curve this north, and typically when that happens, it recurves out to sea. Not a 100% chance of that yet, but a pretty fair chance this one stays east of the United States. The Gulf of Mexico stays quiet. And there's the intensity guidance on Sam. Again, this is expected to be a Category 3 hurricane in about 72 hours. We'll watch it, but again, no issues for the Gulf anytime soon. So model fans, let's go. Here's the GFS. This is the 12Z run, valid tomorrow at 4, a new trough coming into the upper Midwest, and again for us, just gorgeous. A sunny day tomorrow, highs in the upper 70s after starting the day in the 40s in many areas. This is Saturday, beautiful day, sunny, the high close to 80. Sunday, sunny with low 80s. And next week, we're still dry. We'll be up in the mid-80s most days, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday. Go to a week from today. This is Thursday the 30th. Got troughing off the East Coast, troughing coming down across the Rockies. And again, showers off to the west, but we are still dry. We'll go out 10 days. This is Sunday, October 3rd. Upper low over the Middle Atlantic coast, upper low across the Great Plains states. And again, no evidence of any rain here. This is the rain for Birmingham coming off the GFS ensemble. I mean, not much at all. The mean under 0.5 inch between now and the 8th of October. After our cool air, highs next week go back in the mid-80s, lows in the 60s, which is seasonal for the end of September. And the CPC outlook, the latest one in the house here, this is for September 30th through October the 6th, suggesting temperatures close to or maybe slightly above average. That's it for the Weather Xtreme video this afternoon. We'll have notes on the blog. The next video here by 6 o'clock tomorrow morning. You can catch us this evening on ABC 3340 News at 4, 5, 6, and 10 o'clock. Thanks for watching. Have a great evening and God bless. Hey, this is James Spann. I think one of the best parts of my job, getting to do weather programs in schools. During regular times, I'm in a school once or twice a day, teaching students, mostly in elementary schools, things about weather and science. It's a really great part of my job. In fact, if I wasn't a television meteorologist, I would be a third grade science teacher. But one thing I've noticed over the years, some children, not all, but some, develop a genuine fear, a phobia of weather, especially thunderstorms and tornadoes. To offset that, I commissioned a couple of creative members of my family to write a series of children's books about weather. And the first one is out. Benny and Chipper, Be Prepared, Not Scared. Your kids will absolutely love Benny the Bear and his best pal, Chipper the Beagle Dog. It's a really good read about thunderstorms and tornadoes and how it's okay to be a little afraid, but you don't have to be really afraid. As long as you're prepared, you understand them, you know what to do, and you take care of yourself. Information is very powerful, and that starts a process of kids overcoming that fear. And this book is a really good read for any elementary school student. My friend Ginger Z of ABC News in New York, the chief meteorologist there, wrote a foreword here. Jeremy Davis, an illustrator, really makes Benny and Chipper come to life. It's a great read, and your kids will love it. I would encourage you to get a copy, and we'll have future books with Benny and Chipper about things like thunderstorms and the science behind them, tornadoes and hurricanes. So get your copy today. Right now it's available online at Spannbook, with two N's, spannbook.com. And you'll see some other cool stuff there as well. Benny and Chipper, Prepared Not Scared. Get your kids a copy today.